The only question you have to ask yourself is, are you ready for
the Big Spoon Challenge? Let's go! Yes, I can. Doubt better leave. I'm running with this plan. Pull me, grab me, grab us in the bucket. Can't happy. I'll be the president one day. January 1st. Oh, you like that gossip? Like you the one drinking what gossip.com. Now I got a word for your tongue. How many Rolling Stones you want? Yeah, I got a brand new spirit speaking and it's done. Woke up on the side of the bed like I... Hey, everyone. Welcome to episode 2 of Physical Education with Mr. Clarke. I hope you all had a fantastic long weekend. I hope you didn't overindulge in too much chocolate. I definitely bit off more than I could chew with a chocolate lint bunny rabbit last night. It's a horrible decision. Anyway, today we are going to be doing the Big Spoon Challenge. Our main focus is going to be on fine motor skills. Now, fine motor skills are our ability to use the smaller parts of our body to carry out tasks, whether it's picking up a spoon, doing up buttons, writing with a pencil. There's all kinds of different fine motor skills that we actually use throughout the day. The opposite of that is gross motor skills, which are large movements with large body segments. So we use our full legs to run. We use our entire arm and upper body to throw. We use our entire body to sit down, to stand up, to do a somersault, things like that. So we will be using some gross motor movements, but with our main focus being on our fine motor skills today. So buckle up, let's go have some fun. So what we're going to do, we're just going to discuss what we need for today's challenges and then get her going. So number one, you need a big spoon. It can be wooden, plastic. You can use a smaller spoon if you want to challenge yourself. So that is absolutely an option as well. The other thing that you're going to need is tin foil. You're not going to need a whole lot. All you're going to do is you're going to take out about 10 to 12 inches, give or take, rip it off, and you're going to roll it into a ball. Now, just be careful. It can be a little bit pointy and a little bit rough on your hands, so you might want to get mom and dad to do that. So while working on today's motor skills, the goal of our challenges is to try and keep this tinfoil ball on the large spoon without dropping it. Yes, there will be some gross motor movements as well. We will be walking, we'll be running, we might be even doing a little bit of jumping, but we are gonna work on our fine motor movements of attempting to balance this tinfoil ball on this large spoon. Let's get at it. In today's video, we're actually gonna break the challenge up into 3 mini challenges. Hello, Nova. So what we're going to do, the first mini challenge is to be able to balance our big spoon and our tinfoil ball while weaving the spoon in and through a laundry drying rack. Hopefully you guys have one. If not, you can skip this challenge and then just go to challenge number 2. All right, I'm gonna start on this side and I'm gonna weave it through the bottom level, through the middle level, and then through the top level without trying to drop it. Let's give it a go here. So. Over and down. Oh my. Come down. Move down. Move up. And come down. And up. And down. And up. Woo! Let's go! Key reminder, always celebrate. Every time. With mini challenge number 1 wrapped up, we're gonna move on to mini challenge number 2, which is the stair climb. Follow me to the stairs. For this challenge, we have to go up the stairs as quickly as possible and then come back down the stairs as quickly as possible without dropping the tinfoil ball. Remember, the first time you try it, go relatively slow, get the hang of it, and then try and speed up your time. Here we go. So my time was 10 seconds. Nova thinks she can beat it. I guess we'll just have to wait and see. Mini challenge number 3 is where it gets really exciting. So what we're gonna do, we're actually going to do an obstacle course challenge. What you're gonna do, you're gonna spread household items kind of all throughout the house or just throughout one room. You can make it as big or as small as you want. I'm gonna start my living room. I'm gonna spread some household materials out, go up the stairs and then into my room. But
at the end of your obstacle course, you must have a cup because you have to put the ball into the cup in order to finish the obstacle course. And if you miss, your run doesn't count. I'll run you through mine.
So Nova is the official obstacle course coordinator. I have to start where she starts on this mat. I'm gonna come up to this pillow, 2 foot jump. I then come over to the laundry rack. I have to weave in and out of the laundry rack with the spoons. I then come in, I have to weave around one chair, weave around a second chair. I'm then gonna come up the stairs as quickly as I can. I'm then gonna climb under that table, come out the other side, up on my bed, and then put the tin foil in the cup. Here we go. So light 'em up, light 'em up, light 'em up, I'm on fire. So light 'em up, light 'em up, light 'em up, I'm on fire.
Well, that does it for our second episode. I hope you guys have fun with all the challenges. Oh, see you later, Big Spoon. I hope you have fun working on your fine motor skills and also a little bit on your gross motor skills. I will be posting my time, so keep track of that. And continue to stay safe, stay healthy, be awesome, and see you for episode 3.